I come from Kenya, specifically Turkana, which is on the northwestern part of Kenya, bordering Ethiopia and Uganda and Sudan. We are communities who live around the lake. We depend on the lake for fishing, for water tables. In southeastern Ethiopia, we have the Mursi, we have the Dasnat, we have the Nyangatum, and other smaller tribes. In Kenya, we have the Turkana, we have the Elmolo, we have the Gabra, we have the Rendile, and the Dasnat were in Kenya. We're looking at a number of about 300,000 peoples in Kenya and about 400,000 peoples in Ethiopia. It's a total of about 700,000 to 800,000 people. Basically, when there's a dam built on that river, the Omo River, it stops flow of water into the lake. Lake Turkana is a saline lake. For its ecological balance, we depend on every freshwater drop, which the Omo River is the one which flows into the lake. Normally, with a dam, there's a flooding effect. Last time there was a flooding effect with the Gibe II, hundreds of thousands of lives of Merile in Ethiopia were lost. And now we're looking at this one, which is a huge dam. It's like four times the Gibe II. And we're looking at with the lake receding in size, that means the water table goes down. We depend on shallow wells for basic survival. That means the water table goes down, we are rendered refugees. The fish die. We have moved from pastoralism, which is proving to be dying out, into fishing just for mere survival. We're looking at a lot of media pressure, we're looking at social pressure, and we're trying to work with different organizations in the European Union who know the loopholes in the European Investment Bank to help us in this, because we do not have the information, but we are trying to liaise with different organizations to help us in this fight.